out, it rains all day. The wife says to me, son, I think this weather's bound to last. She says, oh, some of them will just be the old me of the past. She said, if I she said, I thought you always set up on the day. Then he ran to William Holroyd, and I'll tell you what to say. Now then, Mrs. Holroyd, can you feel a woo? If you can, I'd like to know
what they say.
For they say that there's a big reason at Blackpool, and I thought you would like to know. They say that you can tell when weather's changing by the twitching of your rheumatic pain. So I've just come round to ask you, Mrs. Holroyd, can you feel a light rain?
Now, Mrs. Holroyd said, now we get off, you'll hear the rain today.
So very soon the Blackpool we enjoyed both breeze and spring. We haven't been there very long when I heard a voice around.
See this, Sam, there's Mrs. Holroyd!
And a very she sat on her young chandelier, looking bright and gay. I felt that flabbergasted, I could have held but say. Now then, Mrs. Holroyd, can you feel a woof? If you can, I'd like to know. For they say that there's a big reason in Blackpool, and I thought you would like to know. By the twitching of the rheumatic pain. So I've just come round to ask you, Mrs. Holroyd, can you feel a light rain?
Well, we landed back in London, but I must take the morning and ask them one of our own we had to do about leaves. We're on that stretch of the land, and we heard a little voice, hello. Mrs. Holroyd!
Up a bit!
Mrs. Holroyd gave a yell as though she were in pain. She planted on a wasp nest. So I asked her once again.
Now then, Mrs. Holroyd, can you feel us? If you can, I'd like to know. For the sailor is a big reason in Blackpool. Can tell the weather's changing by the twitching of your rheumatic pain. So I've just gone round to ask you, Mrs. Holroyd.